More commitment 2012 coverage now. Could it be days before we know the winner of the presidential election?
Political analyst Mark Sandalow joins us live from Washington, D.C. So, Mark, what's the chances we will not know the winner tonight or even tomorrow morning?
Good morning, John. Good morning, Nicole. I think the odds are very much against a long, extended repeat of 2000's election. And the reason is, for that to happen, you need a confluence of two events. First, you need a national vote so close that one or two states can tip the balance and send one candidate over that magic 269 electoral vote mark. The second thing you need is the vote in those states to be so excruciatingly close that you got to go to, you know, hanging chads or provisional ballots and such. The odds are against that. Chances are we will know late tonight, early tomorrow morning who the winner is. The polls are very close, and there are at least half a dozen states where the race is basically a tie. So, yes, it is possible this could drag out for a while, but odds are by the time we talk tomorrow, we'll know who the next president is.
So, Mark, what are the chances of the House or the Senate changing hands?
At the beginning of the year, it seemed like a real possibility that Republicans could win the Senate. All they needed were to pick up four seats or three if they win the White House and the vice president breaks the tie in the Senate. At this point, it doesn't look terribly likely. There have been enough Republican candidates who have had poor campaigns that it looks like Republicans could pick up one or two Senate seats. Democrats could even pick up a Senate seat. The control of the Senate's likely to stay the same. In the House, Democrats need to win 25 victories over Republicans in order to have Nancy Pelosi become Speaker again. Even Democrats will tell you that's pretty unlikely. So even though there'll be some shuffling here or there, odds are pretty strong that the status quo remains in Congress.
Well, Mark, in Nebraska, there are two heated races, Republican Deb Fischer versus former Democratic Senator and Governor Bob Kerrey for Ben Nelson's open Senate seat.
And the other race has incumbent Republican Representative Lee Terry versus Democrat John Ewing. So what's Washington saying about those two races?
You know, they're interested that Chuck Hagel, who is not the Chuck Hagel, the former Republican, has actually endorsed Bob Kerrey, that Alan Simpson, the Republican from Wyoming, and Warren Rudman, Republican from New Hampshire, have endorsed the Democratic candidacy of Kerry. That is breaking the sort of partisan thing that goes on in Washington. That said, most people don't expect Kerry to win that election, although obviously it is quite possible. The House election is interesting because you have, you know, a seven-term Republican being challenged. Now, the Republican is likely to win there, but it points out something that is really amazing in House politics. Every 2 years, you have 435 members of the House up for re-election. Even in a year where overwhelming majority of Americans say they can't stand Congress, throw the bums out, it's time for a change, even in a big change year, 90% of incumbents seeking re-election win re-election. So likely we're going to see Republican victory again there. It just means that change happens very, very slowly in the halls of Congress.
Absolutely. Political analyst Mark Sandalow, thanks for joining us live from Washington this